Hey folks, this is Vincent Vinny Jr. with Dad's Gaming Addiction, and today we're going to play some Power Grid. Now, it's been a while since we've last played this game, so we're a little rusty when it comes to the rules, so keep that in the back of your mind. We also just recently picked up an expansion called The Robots, and basically that allows players to play against AI robots. And these robots have body parts, and basically you shuffle up the different body parts at random, and then you pick out the five different body parts, like the head, the feet, the torso, that kind of thing. And, for example, here's all of the heads that are in the game, okay, and you can turn them over, and they tell players how this particular robot will act during that part of the game. So, at random, we've gone ahead and chosen a robot. So, I don't know, what are you going to call the robot? Johnny Five?
No.
Do you know that reference? Johnny Five is alive? No? Short Circuit? No?
No.
Data? We can call it.
Call him Data.
R2-D2? We could call him.
No, call him Data. C-3PO.
C-3PO? Okay.
He does look like a protocol droid.
He does look like a protocol droid. Okay, so I know you guys can't see it.
C-3PO.
All right, we're going to call him C-3PO. But, yeah, he's got an entire body over here. And we'll read off his stuff as we play. The reason why I don't have everything in the picture is because, well, the game is so big, this is as much as I could fit. But if I put the camera too far back, then you won't see what's going on the board. Speaking of the board, since there's only three players, we'll only be playing in the brown, yellow, and green territories. Okay, so we've got the current market and the future market. So we chose a random person. You're going to be the starting player, since you're the youngest, I guess. And that means you get to pick one of these top four to start the auction on. So you're
going to start the auction on this one.
The six. Okay, so that uses garbage.
That's expensive.
It is expensive, but, you know, it only needs one to power a city. So you're going to bid on six. Now, according to the robot over here, C-3PO, his shoulders say phase two. Using the cheapest resources, maximum bid, minimum bid, plus 5 electro. And it took me a while because there's so many different rules in here regarding what these different things mean. When that comes up, it says the robot only bids for the power plants that needs the cheapest resources. If there are several such power plants, he only bids for the power plant with the highest number. So basically, the cheapest resource right now is coal. Which is the brown one. So he'd probably go with this one here. 5 is higher than 4. And this is a hybrid one. So I'm pretty sure that he'd go for this one as opposed to this one. Unless there's another rule in here that I'm missing. Again, this is the first time that we're playing this particular expansion. So I don't know if he prefers hybrids over regular ones or not. But this one does have coal on it. So I'm going to
assume.
All right. So you're going to bid on this one now. We're going to go clockwise. I could bid on this one, or I could not. I think I will not bid on it. So, now, he's not going to bid on it, because it's not the cheapest resource. So, you get it for 6. So, you have to pay the bank $6.
This is your change.
I know, you'll get some change. So, here's 1, 2, 3, 4 electro.
Yeah, dude. And I don't get to do anything.
All right, now, so we have to draw a new card, and then refresh. Okay, 13. So, these move.
I got for free.
7 moves up here. This is wind. There's no resource needed for that one, which is nice. But that's the future market.
I'm getting that.
Yeah, I know. I like the wind, too. It's nice not having to buy resources.
Or water. Water is a really good one, too.
All right. Well, the reason why we're auctioning first instead of determining player order... Normally, we would determine player order as the first step. But in the very beginning of the game, you skip that. And you sort of switch the two around because everyone's equal at the beginning. We determine player order by the number of cities they have on the board. If there's a tie there, then whoever has the higher numbered power plant. So, now it's my turn. I'm going to go ahead and bid on something. I'm going to go ahead and bid on this 4 here. And now him, he's going to go for the one... now, this is not the highest number, though. So, he would only bid on the one that has the higher number, which is the 5, according to the rules. I mean, I could be wrong about that.
And the cheapest material, which is...
Well, is he going to bid? But it says here, it says, the robot only bids for the power plant that needs the cheapest resources.
Yeah.
If there are several such power plants, he only bids for the power plants with the highest number. So the highest number here is 5.
So you can bid a 4.
I could do this, and you can't bid on me because you've already got one this turn. So I'm going to do this one for 4.
And then those move up.
Alright, well yeah, let me get change.
Is wind not cheapest?
Alright, so we'll see. We'll see.
He might have to peel a bit on wind.
But now he's going to probably do the 8.
Yeah.
That's a 40, holy cow. Okay, so now the highest number is an 8 in the current market.
Empire is 6 cities.
So he's going to buy this one. Since this is the highest number, there's 3 coal here. So he's going to get that one in his possession, and that's going to cost him 8. Now, his special ability, by the way, at the game start, he gets 100 electro. So he has more electro than anyone else right now.
We didn't give him electro.
He has 50. He has 100 right here. So it's near the bank. So I have to pay 8 to the bank for him, and so he gets 2 back. All right, now...
Good job.
Now we determine the player
order. C3.
Now, we don't have any cities down, but... He's got an 8, so he is first on the player order track. You're second, and I am third, meaning I'm last player.
Well, come on. Why C-3PO?
C-3PO wants the biggest city. All right, so now we're going to move on to phase 3, which is
building
resources. The last player on the track goes first. Now, I've got coal. I don't know if you guys can see my power plants or not. If I move them over here.
Oh, but it's...
See, again, it's really hard to get everything in the picture, but okay. I've got a coal power plant here, and I'm going to need some coal for that. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to buy... now, a power plant can store double its production. So it uses 2 coal to produce or to power 1 building, so I can hold 4 there. So I'm going to buy 4 resources, 3 at 1 and 1 at 2, so that's 5. So 1, 2, 3, 5. So I have to spend 5 electro to... And that's, is that my money? That's, yes, my money. All
right,
so...
Right there.
Now, next player is you. You get to buy up to 2 garbage if you want. It costs 7 apiece.
14.
So. Oh, we forgot to draw a new card for the thing here.
I'll just buy 7.
25, okay.
Here.
So you're gonna buy 1.
Yeah. Okay. Give me 3.
Hold on.
Wait, give me a 5.
Why?
I have to pay 7.
Well, I'll just give you 3. No, keep the. You need 1s because you're gonna be bidding on stuff in the future, right?
Yeah.
So wait, what did you give me? A 10?
Yeah.
Okay. So and how much was the? It was 7. So yeah, I gave you 3. Okay. Alright, now the robot, buying resources, all resources. So he's going to buy as much as possible. That's what it says here, all resources. So he's going to buy as much as possible.
He has to buy 4 coal.
As much as his storage allows, I'm assuming. All resources.
You can buy 6.
The robot buys as many resources as possible. If he doesn't have enough money, he leaves the most expensive resources in the market. So he's going to be buying up all this coal. So he's going to do this, 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 and this. So this is... 2, 4, and then 7, 10, 13, and then 17. So he's going to put all of these here, and that's 17. So he put 17 electro into the bank. I'm going to put 20 in. That's a lot of coal. All right. And then he gets 3 change.
He only gets to power 2. Those are the one I wanted to buy.
Okay.
That 10. It gives you 2 for 2.
Mm-hmm. All right. So after we do that, we've purchased the resources.
I want that
building. Last player on the track goes first. So am I going to build a city? I think I might. Let me see where would be a good place to put it. I think I might start in Washington. Oh, better yet, I think I'll start in Philadelphia.
Darn you.
And that's 10 electro.
I'll just start in Pittsburgh. You know,
sorry, so that's 10 electro from me to do
why?
That.
Because Pittsburgh's amazing.
I know, we live in Pittsburgh, I know. But Philly has a nice little connection to New York there, and there's no connection cost. So that would be nice. But anyway, now you get to go. You get to build... you have to build a... You have to buy a power plant on your first turn, but you can't... You can, I think, pass as far as this goes.
I'll start... Darn, I can't stop in Oklahoma. That was a good connection there.
And while you're doing that, I'm going to look up the rules for building. His says all cities, so let me see what that means. The robot builds as many cities as possible. Okay.
I'll start in Chicago.
Chicago.
Guess look. Look at the connections I can make.
That's a lot of connections. All right, so you have to pay 10 electro.
10 electro. Here you go. All
right.
I paid a lot of money.
All right. Now, we all cities. Now, where do we put it, though? The robot builds as many as possible. Building. The robot chooses one city after the others and always finishes the building of one city, including payment. He always chooses the cheapest connection. If there are several cities with the connection price, the robot determines randomly as described. If
he gets Washington, D.C. It's the cheapest.
After the other one always finishes the building of one city, including the payment. Even if it would be... Alright, wait. It says...
That's cheap.
It says here that the robot chooses one city after the other and always finishes the building of one city, including the payment. See, some of this is a little confusing to me.
He gets the cheapest. Which this would be the cheapest connection.
No. No, hold on. He chooses the cheapest connection if there are ours. But that's if he already has one on the board. If you were here, he would choose the Atlanta to Knoxville because it's 5 instead of 7. I think that's what that means. But where do we put the first city?
It doesn't matter. I think we put anywhere we want.
We'll put it...
Away.
We'll put it in the green territory, I guess.
Yeah, put him here. Buy him Miami.
Well, no, it would have to be somewhere... The robot pays in full... Okay.
Yeah, do Tampa.
He always chooses the cheapest connection. If there are several cities, the robot decides randomly as described above. What do you mean randomly?
We randomly put him somewhere.
As it says above. What are you talking about randomly? This is what I'm... we're new to this. We don't know what the hell that means. We're going to randomly put them in green. Fine. If you guys happen to know the answer to where the first robot city goes, let us know. But we're going to, because we don't want this video to go on for too long, I'm going to put him in Tampa down here. He'll pay 10. And there's still cheap connections there. So, 10.
You need to go to Miami or Jacksonville.
No, he's going to buy as many as possible. That's his thing. So he's going to build another city. To Miami or Jacksonville. So
he goes both, actually.
Probably. So he's going to go to Jacksonville.
For 14 and another 14.
This is 14. He has enough for it. So, yeah, let's do that. My God. This guy's a maniac. C-3PO's gone mad with power and money. He thinks he's a landlord. Like, what the hell? He's got 28... All right, so that's 28 that he has to pay. I'm going to have to do the 50 and then change. He's got so much money. He starts with 100 because of his special ability. So that was 28. So that's 22 and change. So he has that. And I think it would still allow him to buy something. The next is the cheapest. There's no connection cost to Savannah. So that's 4 now. He has to pay 10. You're kidding me. Now he has to choose 7. Okay, does he have? He has $17. So he's gonna make a connection to Raleigh or Atlanta.
Raleigh.
Random. Okay, he's gonna come up. He's crazy. C-3PO, slow down, dude. We just started. My God, C-3PO.
How much money does he have left? He can make a connection here.
Someone needs to. They wiped his memory for a reason.
Now he makes a connection here.
He does. He's got enough money for it. It's only cost 3 to move into Norfolk. The game's going to be over. Holy. 13. All right, he's only got a few bucks left. So, yeah, we need to adjust our things. We each have 1. He's got 6. Count again. He's got 6.
Jesus.
Yeah, he's got, how much money does he have left? He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. My God. What the heck, C-3PO? Now, maybe there are rules in here that forbid him from doing that, but I don't...
Look how much money he
no,
gets.
No, because one of them says...
No, look how much money he gets now.
Well, no, they have to be powered. He's not going to get that much money because he only gets money for powered He only can power he can only power two of these cities. That's what I mean, like building. All cities never more than the first player cannot build through plus only supplied cities. Okay, so there is actually one that says the robot only builds up to as many cities as he can supply with energy. But this one says all cities. So we were right. We did the right thing. There was a body part in here that said that he could only build up to a supply limit. But in this case, he's just mad. He's like, whatever.
Z3PO,
I'm just gonna buy all of the United States in one turn. That's what I'm gonna do. He thinks he's Donald Trump. What's that? Like, seriously, he's like, whatever, buy everything.
It's C-3PO Donald Trump.
Is there a C-3PO Donald Trump protocol droid on Star Wars? I don't know.
No, it's C-3PO.
Okay, well.
He's a little coward.
He is a coward. That's true.
No, he looks nervous, you know. He doesn't make facial expression. He still looks nervous.
Yeah, I know he does. All right, so let's just... All right, so he's done building, finally. Then bureaucracy. The first player goes.
One.
So the first player, which is him, cash. Trade in resources on their power plants. So he's going to trade in three of the brown here to the supply. To power two of these. And he gets money. Now, the money he gets is... let me look at my...
No, he powers four houses.
No, he does. No, he can only supply up to your...
Yeah.
That's for a future turn. He only supplies it once. See, he can only do that once per turn.
Yeah, he gets...
So he gets two. It's $33 electric.
So he can buy more houses.
Probably. He's going to be first player for quite a while, I think. All right, so he's got...
No, the game's going to be over, like, not even that long.
Well, the game end triggers when there's number of connected cities to trigger game end, 17. So, yeah. There's already eight down. Okay, so... But I think he's slowing down now that he doesn't have as much money. He starts off with a bunch of money. It's just this particular combination that allowed him to buy so much at once. So, alright, so now the next player, blue...
Yeah!
Alright, so you get to trade in one yellow to power one city, and that gives you how much money?
22.
22?
I need two tens and two ones.
I know how to count to 22, thank you. I am an accountant. If I couldn't give you $22, then there'd be a problem. Here you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And I can supply one city.
I'm such a gentleman.
So I'm going to trade in brown for that. I've got two brown left on that card.
I'm such a gentleman.
Okay. 22.
Right now, guess what he can do? He can buy more things to get all this money again. To buy all these cities again. All
right. Okay, so... Now we replenish the market. That is for three players on step one. We're currently on step one. When does step two happen? Step
no.
two happens when there's 10 cities. So we're almost on step two already. Wow. Oh, no, seven. Oh, really? Step two, seven. We actually have enough for step two. That is crazy. Okay, so I've never been to step two this quickly before, even remembering when we last played. So what happens then during step two that I missed?
What? That doesn't make any sense.
During step two, when one player is 10 cents... Okay.
We picked a horrible...
Just this once, remove the lowest plant from the market from the game and draw to replace.
Okay.
All right. Now, there's also a rule in Power Grid that... If at any time a player has power plants that are,
What?
The number of cities they have is more, equal to or more than what's out here. Like the five and the seven, for example. So the five, the five would also go. Because the computer player has six, and that would make the five go away. So the let's draw and see what this is. 17. Okay, so the 13 comes up here, and there you go. Okay. Stop playing with the table. Leave it alone. Okay, so now we replenish the market. Per the chart, replenish the market on the... Okay, so we're in step two. Three players. That's five coal. So that's one, two, three, four, five.
He's buying coal again.
Oil is three, so three black.
And a bit of
oil. Oil's pretty cheap. Waste. And then two garbage.
Oh, only two?
Well, when you buy it, it's six now instead of seven. And then finally, one uranium.
Of course, Iridium's like the cheapest thing in the world.
And then finally, upgrade the market. Place the highest power plant in the future market and place it under the... So the highest is actually... This needs reordered. All right, the highest is 40. That goes on the bottom, and then we draw to replace that.
Darn
so
it.
That is 24, so that goes here.
Darn it, that 25 looks good.
Yeah, five houses.
How about that one?
All right, so now we determine player order. Yeah. In this case, he's got the most cities. He goes first place. Second place, between you and me, I've got a 4, you've got a 6, so the turn order stays the same. So that's done.
Oh, you got that.
I get first pick.
Now.
I get first pick. I will bid
13.
But see, if I go for the coal, he's going to go for coal too.
I'll bid you on that stupid window. I want power.
Well, maybe.
I want
power. See, this it depends on how many cities I plan to
do that one, the oil.
You know what? I will do the oil because
it'll give you more houses.
Well, no, because now he's going to bid on the oil. Because that's now the cheapest resource out of all of them. I could buy this. I could go for the 13, and I wouldn't need a resource for that at all, which would be nice. I wouldn't have to worry about.
But I want that.
I know you want it. All right, let's do this. I'll bid on the 7. Now.
No, do the coal. Do that coal. Because look, coal is the cheapest right now, so he's not gonna go for it.
No, coal is not the cheap. Well, oil is the cheapest.
Yeah, he's gonna go for that, not the.
Well, if there's a tie between the two, what does he go
after?
There
isn't.
Well, there is, because... No, because I don't get these 3
You
yet.
Go for the 9.
First of all, I'm going to pick the 7. Are you going to bid on this?
No.
Now, is the computer going to bid on this? That's the question. The cheapest resource is both coal and oil. So the question is, will he bid on this, or will he stick with coal? Or does he stick with coal?
He'll have to bid here.
He'd bid for the highest number, which is 9. All right.
You're safe.
All right, so even if he does, all right, so let's go ahead and I'm going to have to do this.
That moves up, 17 moves up. All
right, well, let's, 11. So these move over, and that goes there. All right, now it is your
Holy
turn.
Holy crap.
That's it's uranium for 2 power, or 2
I'm
cities.
Thinking of buying that, but then I'm getting the windmill.
The windmill?
Yeah.
All right, now the question is, does he bid on, what is that considered the cheapest resource? Is wind the cheapest resource?
No.
For the power plant that needs the cheapest resources. He only bids for the power plant with the highest number. But what about wind?
Maybe it doesn't say. I'm getting a 13 out. 1.
All right, it doesn't actually say. When I think power plant, I mean, this is a wind turbine, not a power plant. So I'm thinking that he ignores these and goes for the ones with the cheapest resources. So, all right, so that means that you get this for 13. He's not going to bid on it.
And I get 2 houses.
Well, no, you can support up to that many. All right. Now, is drawn 33. Now, this 17 moves up.
Holy crap!
What?
4 houses.
That's
for free.
Well, yeah, but you have to pay 33 to get it. It's a wind turbine.
I'll pay for it.
So now the computer will buy one. Now, again, the cheapest resource is either, but the highest number is 10. So there's a tie for brown and black here, but the higher number is 10, which is coal. So he's going to buy this for 10.
I'm buying uranium. Like, uranium is, like, higher.
All right, so he gets that, and he's going to pay 10 electro to get it.
We should buy uranium. Look how uranium. Look how high.
Well, let's
draw
to replace 37. Holy cow! Right, this comes up.
No, 37's highest.
There's another wind turbine. Set of wind turbines. So
I'm getting that.
All right, probably. All right. So now everyone's got one there. So now
I can power 4 houses at once for free. Those windmills are like powerful. They can power a house or a city pretty quickly.
Buying resources. Last player on the track goes first. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and buy... I'm going to buy 2 coal. And I'm going to buy... no one else has oil. So I may consider... Well, I need at least 3 for that. So this is 2, 4, 6. Am I going to go with more? He's going to buy as much coal as possible. So I'm going to go ahead and... Well, no, I can only buy up to 2 brown anyway, because I can only hold that much. But I'm going to go ahead and buy... Is anyone going to go for oil next turn? I don't foresee that happening. So I'm going to leave... I'm only going to do the 3 oil. So that's 2, 4, 6, and then this is... That was 8, and then 11. So I have to pay 11 electro.
Oh, my. 13.
To get these resources, and they go on my cards. Okay. Now, you're next. You get to pay for resources. Basically, it's
13.
for one guard. What are you going to do?
2 garbage.
All right, so 6 and 7, that's 13. Okay. So
it's strategy.
Okay. All right, so give me your money, and I'll put it in the bank for you.
But now I can supply myself for 2 turns.
Yes, you can.
This turn and next turn.
Although, if you want to think about strategy, and you can't take this back now because I'm telling you about it, no one else has garbage. So you could have waited. You can only buy one now, and then when the market resupplies at the end of the round, you could buy it for 6 again instead of paying for 7. That's what I would have done.
No, it covers 2, I think. Garbage, so I still got 6.
Well, when garbage replenishes, though, it's going to go back into the 6. And then when you buy it next turn, it'll only be 6 again instead of 7. It's only 1 buck, 1 electro, so it's not that big of a deal.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not going to be buying it yet.
Buying where he did that. Oh, him. He's going to buy resources. So he can buy...
He has to buy
all resources. So all the coal that he can afford. He's got... All right. Well, he can buy one.
The worst combination.
Well, he can hold 3 on the first card, and 4 on the second one. So that's 7. So let's see if he can afford 7. So it's 3, 6, and then 10, 14, 18, and then 23, 28. Does he have 28 bucks? He has 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. All right, so he cannot afford the last one. So he's going to put them on his cards like that. I guess he supplies the higher number. Okay. So so he bought...
A lot of money.
Yeah, so it's going to be... again, it was...
5 minus less. 5. So 28 minus 5
is 23.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so he pays 23 to the bank. Now, he's not going to be able to buy any cities, though. Not with the money he's got left. But no, he's fine, though. Look at him. He's got all those cities anyway. He can now power 4 cities. All right, so after that, building. Last player on the track goes first. That means I get to put more housing down if I want. I can support 2 cities, so I'm going to go ahead and go to New York. There's no building cost. There's no connection there, so it's just 10. So I pay 10 to the bank.
Yeah, Dad, good job.
All right, and I can only support... Actually, you know what? I could do 3 because I might go to Washington here because I want to cut him off from buying, from getting that way. So instead of going to Boston... Well, no, because if I go to Boston, that's 3. If I go to Washington, that's 3. So I have to pay 13 to go that way. So I will pay...
Why Washington?
Because I don't want him going that way. I don't want him cutting me off. So I get 7 back. 1, 2...
I have to block him somewhere.
Well, I'm trying to block him. That gives me another city.
I have to buy 17 for my...
We're on step 2, though. So he could go that way and go into the 15 spot.
I don't have enough money.
Well, that goes... Well, you have 1. I'm up to 3 now.
Am
I going to buy another city? No, because I can only support... 3 to begin with. So I'm not going to buy more cities than I can afford.
I can't buy any cities anyway.
Okay, so now it is your turn. How much money do you have?
13.
So you can't...
buy any houses.
That's fine. I mean, you can store your resources for...
Yeah, I know.
Alright, so you're not going to... Okay, but that puts you into last place coming up. So you get first dibs. Alright, so after that, we're in... Well, he gets the build now, but he doesn't have any money, so he can't do it. Because he's only got a few bucks left.
We get
bureaucracy. First player on the track goes first. Cash, trade in resources. And then, okay, so he's going to give 3 up here and 2 up here. He's go back to the bank. And he powers 4. So that is 54 electro. So I'm going to give him...
What? How much money does...
1, 2, 3.
I'm behind because I can't buy anything.
Relax. You'll get money this turn. One, two, three, four. Yeah, and then money. You'll use it to...
Bought, not buy resources, so...
Well, you bought expensive resources. That's the problem. You bought more garbage than you should have, I think. Like I said, I would have only done one. Anyway, that aside, okay, so now that he's got his money, you go next. You get... How many buildings did you power? One? So you get 20.
Three.
You get
20. For reasons.
All right, so you get 22.
Yeah. Two tens.
And yeah, you can save those months. So when you build your next city, you can use the garbage.
No, then I can do is save, get one ten.
You can't buy it now. You have to wait till your next turn.
I know.
Okay.
No, I'm saving that for later.
Okay. And then I get, I'm going to cash in.
And save up.
Two and then three. To the bank, and I can build three cities, so that's 44 electro. So I get 1, 2, 3, 4.
I think I know what I'm betting on.
And
I'm not betting on oil. Oil is too expensive. Three,
four.
The uranium is going to be the strongest one of them all. Uranium.
Uranium.
Yeah.
Okay, so I got my money. Replenish resources. So per the chart, we're on step two still. For three players, that's 5 coal. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oil is 3. So 1 remains nice and cheap for me. It's awesome. And then 2 garbage.
Yeah, but he has to pay for it because he goes the cheapest.
Well, no, power plant. He goes for the power. He buys the cheapest resources for... 1 uranium. Let's finish this and then we'll argue about that. 10.
Uranium.
Okay. It's not a superpower.
Yes, all right, it is.
Alright, upgrade market. Place the highest power plant under... Okay, so the highest is 37. That goes under here.
What's the next one?
34. So that goes in the back. Okay.
Oh.
1 uranium, 5 power plants. This one can power 5. Okay. So now...
I want that.
All right, so we have to adjust turn order based on... So, actually, me and you just switch locations.
Yeah.
Because I've got 3, you've got 1. So, now you get to go first. Auction power plants. The first
I'm
player
this
picks.
One.
Which one?
Radio.
11 or 17?
Yeah. 11.
Okay, yeah. Do I want uranium?
Uranium can give me 2 houses, so...
I will... I will not bid against you, and neither will he, because this is not the cheapest resource on the market.
Yeah, it's the highest.
The cheapest is oil, so he's going to be going for an oil plant,
unless
something else happens. All right, so here's your... Give me 11 electro.
I'm sorry, I had it all. I love uranium.
Okay. You don't have to keep pounding your
I'm
chest.
The element.
23.
I am the element.
All right, so now...
Really?
My turn, I get to pick one. Yeah, I know, but I don't want to spend 23 electro on this, and uranium is, at the moment, 10.
That's what I'm saying.
So,
the
question is, am I going to go for coal again, or am I going to... This one would give me... That's too many.
You need 17, Jesus.
If I do 9, that's only 1 house that I could build next turn. I could go for the 20, and that's not the cheapest resource, so... And I would get first dibs on oil, so I could buy him out and force him to buy oil at a higher price. So I think I will bid on this one and set myself up for the future.
Yeah, do it.
I could.
And that'll give you 5 houses.
Well, yeah, I wouldn't have to do much. Okay, so I'm going
to
go...
You don't have to get 3 materials right, and 5 houses.
20 electro for that. He's not going to bid on it because the cheapest resource is oil right now. The computer would not go for that. 32. All right. So
he has so much money.
All right. So the cheapest resource is oil, and the highest number is 9. So he's going to go, well, actually, it says here that I read in the rule book that he would not go for one that is a lower number than one he already has now. But.
It's oil.
General rules. The robot never bids on a power plant. The power plant is a lower number than his smallest power plant. Okay, well, his smallest power plant is an 8. So he would still go for it. Okay.
So
he never bids on He never bids on the fourth power plant if it supplies fewer cities than each of his three power plants in his possession.
Which, it's all two, so.
Alright. So, he's gonna go for the nine, because that's the cheap. According to his rules here, using cheapest resources. Maximum bid, minimum bid, plus five electro, so nine. So he's gonna buy this for nine.
There's probably a card that has, you have to use two uranium to power 10 houses. That'd be like six.
Actually, I'll just do the 10.
Just stack up one.
And he gets one in change. You can get four and then we draw one card, 31. So these slide over.
You can do it for four turns.
Alright.
Like
alright. Now, what was I doing? Okay. So we each have a power plant. Next up, we
get resources.
Buying resources.
Do I have to buy resources?
And we can have a maximum of three power plants, by the way. So at some point, when we buy next round, we're going to have to get rid of one.
I'm going to keep my resources.
The last player on... You can't keep your resources once you get rid of it.
No, I mean, I don't want...
Unless you get another one, like the 24, for example. Then you could transfer it over. But anyway... Going in reverse order, you can buy resources. So you get first dibs on resources. So I would...
Do I have to buy...
It's up to you. How many houses do you plan on building this turn? How many?
One.
Okay,
which
so...
Which I can get easily.
Okay, so you don't have to buy any resources if you don't want to.
At least I want to stack on uranium, which I want to buy a house. I wouldn't have enough then.
Are you going to stock up on uranium, or are you going to...
Nah, I'm not going to stock up.
All right, so now it's my turn. I'm next in turn order. So I'm going to buy... six oil. So that's... I'm going to put that
I don't
above.
Get enough money yet. Once I start buying houses, I'll get more money.
And...
Because I can power it pretty quickly with those three cards.
Hmm.
As you...
Question is, how many structures am I going to build this time?
None.
Well, it depends on how much money I'm going to have left after this. Just buying these alone, because I want... this so that I can drive up the price of oil for him because he's going to be buying it for his oil power plant. So this is 2, 4, 6.
We're trying to bankrupt
8, 10, 12. Basically, yes, I'm trying. Oh, no. 2, 4, 6, 9, 12, 15. So this is 15.
Bye bye, C3PO. You're being bankrupt.
All right, so 10 and 5 for 15. All right, so I may buy more though. Give me a minute.
I hate C3PO.
So these are going into my stock here. And coal. Am I going to buy coal? Well,
you might want to save up for buying more houses.
No, because I might want the coal. I mean, it's cheap, pretty cheap right now. I could do one. Why don't I do?
You can pay 20.
Maybe I'll do 4. Okay, so this is 3. But if I do this 3 and then 7 and then 11, 15. If I do that, I may not have enough money to afford... Actually, you know what? I could... Now that I've got this, I just need 3. Actually, no, because when I buy a card on the next turn, I could transfer coal from one to the other. I can't do that. So maybe I'll just buy 1.
For 8 or 3.
For 3. Yeah, I'll just do that. Because I plan to get rid of this plant anyway. So... just $3 for the one resource. And I'm going to save the rest for later. Anyway, he gets to buy stuff now. He's going to buy as much as possible. So he's going to buy... Oh my gosh. He's crazy.
He's not going to buy any houses.
Well, what sucks is, if he doesn't buy coal next... If he doesn't get a coal plant next turn, then he's going to lose all the resources that he's buying up. He's going to buy 1, 2...
Does he have to?
3, 4...
Is it required to?
5, 6...
He's not going to be able to buy houses. Like, that's just...
Well, we'll start with the cheapest one and work our way up. So the cheapest ones are coal and oil right now. So, with oil, it's 2. So that's $8. So he has to pay 8 electro for that.
Gosh!
So 1, 2.
That's just ridiculous. Because he can't buy anything.
Now, coal, he can support 1, he can support 4 on this card. That would be 4, 8, 12, 16. Can he afford 16? Yes, he can.
Why would you want him to pay 16?
And then 1, Actually, I'll just give him a 5 and he'll pay 1 to the bank.
Well, that's this is ridiculous.
All right, so he gets this 4, well...
Now he can't pay...
All right, now he could buy one more colt, or one more... No, he could buy 3 more. 1, 2, 3.
Don't.
For that. Well, no, he has to. It says all resources. Sometimes they make stupid decisions. So this is 5, 10, 15...
He's an idiot.
16. Well, yeah, he's an idiot. But... Does he have 16 bucks? 16, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. He does not. So he has to only buy 10 worth of coal. So one, no, wrong one. One, two.
See, he gets.
So,
he still
10.
Has money as. No, don't use the 5.
4, 5.
No, just get rid of all the 1s. And you'll always just have that 5.
Well, no, because I may want the 1s for later. Okay. So, that's as much as he can afford right now. He's not going to buy any more cities at this point. So now, we move on to the building phase, to where the last player on the track gets to put a city down.
Yeah! Make your own.
All right, go ahead.
I'm going to Detroit.
Detroit.
For 17. Here, just give me a 3. Back.
Settle down. You know, sound effects aren't necessary. 10, 1, okay. So, you have the Blues, so where are you going to go? Cincinnati? Oh, Detroit. Okay, so that goes on the 10 there. All right, are you going to do anything else? Can you buy any more buildings or no?
I only have 7.
Okay. All right, next in line is me, so I get to put more stuff down.
30.
I can go to Boston for 13, which I think I may do. So that's 1, 2, 3.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Alright, so there's that. I'm up
to 4.
You're
not blocking me. I'm going to Cincinnati.
Alright, I've got 12 bucks left, so I really can't do anything else.
If I go to Cincinnati.
Can I think, please? Thank you. The cheapest connection is 16. I can't do it. So I'm stuck with just those 4 right now. So next up is him. He can't buy anything with how much money he has left. So now we're going to move on to building. Last player on the track goes... Oh, we did that. Bureaucracy. First player goes first.
He goes first.
Yeah, cash in resources. Okay, so he's going to cash in 3 of... Well, what does he need to cash in? He's got 6, right? So he can do all of them. Well, 1 for this, 1 oil, and then 3 for this one. And then 2 for this one, that's 5. So he just powered 5. So that's 64 electro.
I'm always going to get first dis on odd goods.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 65, and then 1 and change, 64.
I'm going to have dis on odd goods.
So. All right, and then I get to power... I'm just going to trade in these 3 brown. I'm going to move this one over here. I'm going to trade it to just do the 5 here. And that's 3. That's 5 power. So
you power a warehouse that has 2 power.
And that's 5. I get to power 5 buildings that way. So now I've got
64.
4 electro, which is 54.
Six. Yeah.
So 54, 1.
No, 64.
54, look at again, for 4.
Oh, I think you had 5.
54, 1.
Man, you have...
All right, now you powered how many buildings? 2. You have to give up 1 of those garbage can things.
The garbage.
Garbage. Okay, so how many do you get for 2? 33. So you get 1, 2.
That means I can buy more houses.
3. 1, 2, 3. There you go. Can you not talk while you yawn? It's really annoying. No one can understand you. He gets to. We already did him. Okay, and then replenish. Per the chart. We're still on step 2, so we get 5 coal added to the market.
No.
2. So coal is still relatively expensive. 5.
Yeah, because you keep buying it all.
Boy, that's what the thing tells them to do. 3 for the oil.
Oil, I'm going to buy.
2 garbage.
I'm going to take one of the oil things. Because apparently
and
oil
is 1 uranium.
Wait, you have to pay 25 just to get that card?
Yes.
I don't even have that type of money.
Well, you'll get there.
I do.
Using the build, you need to build more buildings and power them. That's your thing. So
I'm trying to, but all the things are like super dang expensive.
Alright, so turn order is going to be the same, because he's got more houses, I've got second, you've got two.
I'm not going to buy anything.
Alright, so determine player order. You don't have to buy any of these if you don't want to. You can pass.
Okay.
Alright, determine player order. Did that auction power plants. First player, which is you, so you're going to pass. That means you're out of the round. Alright, now it's my turn. I get to choose one. Am I going to buy any? Am I going to buy any of these four? The answer to that is hell to the no, because they're too expensive.
You think? Some of them are freaking 90.
I'm not paying 17 and then 8 for uranium, so I'm going to pass as well. He is going to...
I won.
The max you can have is 3, so he's gonna try and be efficient here. The cheapest resource is oil, but he can't do that. The next is coal. So that means that he's going to go for the highest number, which is 25.
Which is
so he's going to bid. He's going to pay 25 for that one. So he gets 25. Okay. So he's increasing his power plants. Now this 4 goes away. All right.
10, 14, and then...
Okay. Or no, that was me that I just knocked off mine. All right, so wait. His is 8. So I'm going to move his 8 out of here. Move his 9 and 10 and up, and now he is. Okay, so he has a 9 with oil, 10 with coal, and a 25 with coal. For those of you that can't see, again, I could free cam this, but, you know, I get some complaints sometimes. All right, so I don't know if I can move the camera over this way. The downside is you won't be able to see Vinny's stuff at all. But if I do this, this is what he currently has over here. He's got his 3 power plants over here. Some are powered, some not. Okay, so let's move it back over this way. Sorry, folks. Don't mean to make you sick. All right.